Hi, and welcome back to the 11th video about our DevSecOps pipeline, which we are creating with GitLab. In our past videos, we have created this DevSecOps pipeline together with GitLab. We have introduced 6 tools which ensure the security of our application. And we have added over there the merge requests. And for that, we have created in total 10 videos about this DevSecOps pipeline and how you can build this pipeline and ensure your quality with this pipeline. Now, Padi, now we are really secure with that pipeline, right? Now we are done.
Not really. There's one thing left. Imagine what happens if you have code in production, so your product is actually running there. And now time passes and there are new vulnerabilities found in dependencies you have. Well, you want to be aware of these changes. And for this, we can introduce scheduled pipelines. Scheduled pipelines is all about running the security tests, so the pipeline on the branch that contains the code that's currently in production. To implement this, we define a scheduled pipeline run for the branch in production within GitLab, and we will have to change the pipeline definition, so the GitLab CI.yaml file, to exclude all those tasks that are not relevant for these runs.
That's interesting. Why are we not running all of our jobs or all of our tasks for the production code? Should we not run everything?
Well, we could technically, but there is a big advantage if we do it not everything at all in one go. In particular, some things are not changing over time. So if a regular test runs now, it will also run in 3 months from now, even if something outside changed. It has no impact on the inside. Mm. But there's other things like vulnerabilities within dependencies or third parties that might be found in the meantime. So we have security researchers actually looking for new vulnerabilities, and they might identify a new vulnerability within a dependency you use.
So Padi, then this would mean that we just need to execute the dependency scan, so the SCA scan.
Well, in our case, also the container scan job would be very valuable, for obvious reasons, namely because it's the actual Docker image that's run in production. And this one may have additional vulnerabilities identified too. And with these two, SCA, dependency scanning, as well as the container scanning, most likely that's good enough for everyone and everything. Now, what do we need for a scheduled pipeline for production? We need to have a distinct release branch set up. Then we create a scheduled runner that contains a variable named scan only, for example, set to true. And we update the pipeline definition in our GitLab CI.yaml file to decide, based on this variable, whether that task should run or not. This is done by adding a rule at the very end of a task. For example, for the test task or test job, we would add like this: rules, and if scan only variable is set to anything, then we never run this task. Let's see where we set up a new scheduled pipeline run. This is done under CI/CD schedules. And here you can add a new schedule to run a pipeline. What's important here is to select the branch that contains your production release and that you set up a variable scan only to any value. And with that, you can save the pipeline and schedule it for run.
And now, Padi, now we are finished with our DevSecOps pipeline. Now we are secure. Is that right?
If we do all of this, we're on the very best path that's possible. And I'd say our DevSecOps journey now can end. And let's make a last session to the topic of what are our personal recommendations, what to do or not to do.